Myra Pollock Sadker once said, "Each time a girl opens a book and finds a womanless history, she learns she is worth less." It's basic math. Women are half of humanity. They should be half the content in history classes. But sadly, they have not been, and Remedial History is here to fix that. Welcome to Remedial History, where we ask what happened to the women and put them in. In this series, we tell women's history from era to era from the perspectives of differing and diverse women. Women are half of history. Welcome to Her Story. History tends to be dominated by military, diplomatic, and economic themes that systematically exclude women. But history is the study of the past, and we know that women were there. We know that women lived, felt, were impacted, and impacted history. But why are aspects of history in which women played dominant roles still not included? Where is the history of child rearing, social reform, medical history, and so many others in which women played dominant roles? These histories will expand our cultural understanding of both the past and the present. Even in the economic, military, and political spheres, women continue to hold positions that they have for centuries. Women have been monarchs, empresses, and politicians. Women, especially poor women, have always worked outside of the home. In some cases, the only histories we have about women were written by men, but they were still documented and are still there. Beginning in the 20th century, women's history programs and women's studies programs popped up all around the world on college campuses. And there is so much scholarship today about women that's available to us that should be in our classrooms. Sadly, today, only 40% of high school social studies teachers are women, and only 35% of people with PhDs are women. This is problematic because only 6% of male historians choose to write and research women. State standards name women at a rate of 1 for every 3 men that are mentioned. State textbooks, on average, name women at a rate of 1 for every 4 men that are mentioned. Only 7% of outdoor statues are of women recognizing their accomplishments, and 28% of recent biographies were written about women. So what we're working against here is pretty significant. There's not a lot of research, and there aren't a lot of things that recognize the accomplishments of women out there to be incorporated into the classroom. A plurality of high school social studies teachers implement women's history once a month or less. And these are pretty grim statistics, but they don't have to be. The national social studies standards are very skills-centered. They're not driven by content. And most states have pretty abysmal state standards for social studies, if they exist at all. And that's a huge gray area where individual teachers have the opportunity to determine the content that's in their classrooms. We can get women's history into your classroom. Women's history gives us a window into the history of gender and sexuality as well. Inclusive women's history should include the history of gender nonconforming people, as well as a variety of sexual identities. It allows us to reevaluate the gendered biases and gendered norms throughout time and look at how gender norms impact people of all genders. For example, a lot of historians make pretty gendered assumptions about the skeletons they find at different burial sites that have swords and shields buried with them. Why is someone buried with a shield considered male? A lot of DNA evidence is now coming forward to show that those bodies were actually the bodies of female soldiers from the past. Why does this happen? Historians, mostly male, make gendered assumptions about the bodies that they're finding based on the cultural norms of when they're living, not the cultural norms of the bodies that they're discovering. Across time and cultures, gender norms vary considerably, and we're here to study that. Our videos will provide a foundation, an introduction into the study of gender across time. We will help you learn about some of the major women, major issues that impacted those women throughout time. We will provide a foundation from which you can go and look and do further study. On our website, you can find primary sources, lesson plans, and all sorts of things to expand on what we're providing for you in these videos. By the end of our series, you will see the myriad ways women transformed and were transformed by history, not just in traditional women's topics, but all of history. When you're studying history and you come across a period or an event where you didn't learn about any women who were present, I'm going to challenge you to consider that women were there and begin to ask, where are the women? You might find that you begin to contribute to the field of women's history, which is an emerging field. There is so much more to learn and discover about women's history. You might find that one of our videos is missing somebody pretty significant, and that's because so much more research is coming out right now about women. Imagine a world where people know women and gender history. Imagine how that could transform our cultural understanding of gender and gender dynamics. Is it possible that a deeper understanding of our history can produce better gender equity today? Thanks for watching. If you want to dive deeper, head over to our website, www.remedialherstory.com. You can find lesson plans, primary sources, video recommendations, and so much more. Let's make herstory.